Hi, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you so much for being here. I was concerned that after lunch and before coffee, there'd be very few people in the room. Of course, the speaker before me has helped hugely, but thank you again very much. So, how does branding help your company, and what does it take to create a brand? We're talking about your company, and so there is a proposition that really starts from what your company is and what your brand will become. What does the brand proposition take? What it takes is a physical presence. You have a physical presence in the UAE. You could be in any sector, real estate, hospitality, education, financial services, anything really. You have a set of products and services that you're already marketing to consumers in the marketplace. And that could be real estate projects, it could be education, it could be marketing consultancy services, such as a company of mine provides Market Vision, it could be RTA, it could be Seva, Mr. Aleem's company. And then there must be a plan for development and growth. And when I say that, I'm talking about new products, new services, improved products, improved services, a new food product that is being distributed by a food distributor in the UAE, a new school, a new college. And these then constitute the physical attributes of the business that you run, the company that you run. And that contribute in turn to revenues and in turn to profits. But there are some companies that operate more than just a business. And they then achieve some kind of leadership status in the sector in which they operate, which elevates them to something beyond what the entire sector in which they operate represents. An example here would be MR. There are a huge number of developers in this economy. But when you think of MR, you think of Burj Khalifa, and you say, MR is the company that created the tallest building in the world. So it has an association with the tallest building in the world, which already differentiates it from all other developers. MR also has address hotels. It didn't just build those hotels, it then set up a management team. And it's now an important hotel management company, which is a step way beyond what a developer is expected to be. And so, MR is just one example. Christopher took the example of Tesla electric cars, completely disrupted the automotive industry. And you're looking at an industry now which is looking at electric cars as an alternative to the traditional modes of road transportation that the world has become accustomed to. GEMS, as an education company, they have a global education and skills foundation, a forum, where they bring on an annual basis people like Bill Clinton, Bill Clare, academicians, government officials involved in education across the world. And they have a forum where they award a $1 million prize to the best teacher in the world. And so they've taken themselves way beyond what the other education companies in this economy represent to a company that is not just the single largest provider of school education in the world, but something even higher and more elevated than that. And that is brand. That's the goodwill, etc., that goes into the brand, into the proposition that the company offers, and creates a brand where other companies remain simply companies. Who are the stakeholders that impact brand? The first stakeholder that we look at is the external stakeholders, brand users, really. Who are these? These are existing customers, these are potential customers, these are influencers on social media, etc., who determine if new people will go into using and consuming that product because of their influential efforts. There are the strategic allies and others, brand presence, determinants, trade channels, strategic allies, suppliers of raw materials, etc. There's the financial audiences on the third platform, debt providers, investors, governments offering soft loans at maybe 1% and 2% when the commercial rate of interest is 8-10%, in the hope that the company will be able to achieve something which is important on a social platform for the economy. And then, of course, the brand managers, which is the internal stakeholders, starting with the directors on the board to the employee at the lowest level, the PM, the sweeper, etc., and of course, sales and production, middle managers. These are the people in totality that determine what your brand will be and how it is perceived in the marketplace. And that